Grace and peace unto you one more time. I am being commissioned to preach the word.
Amen.
In season
and out of season.
Hallelujah. And this morning I want to speak to you on the topic, be saved by the gospel. 1 Corinthians 15 verse 1. Now brother, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, which you receive, on which you have taken your stand. By this gospel you are saved, if you hold firmly to the word I preached to you. Otherwise you have believed in vain. For what I receive, I pass on to you as the first important, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures, and that he appeared to Peter and to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers at the same time, most of whom still living, and those some has fallen asleep. The word of God has been preached. What is the gospel? Man is a sinner, my God, and cannot save himself. You see, my brothers and sisters, we were born in sin, and we were shaped in iniquity. In sin did our mother conceive us. You got to understand that we were given the old Adamic nature. Because Adam has sinned in the Garden of Eden, through the disobedient, he has listened to the serpent. And the serpent has beguiled Eve, and Eve has tricked Adam. And both were being deceived through the spirit of disobedience. Now, my brothers and sisters, oh hallelujah, because of sin, oh hallelujah, the whole human race, oh hallelujah, were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. We didn't have to do nothing to be a sinner. We were just born a sinner. We didn't have to curse or to do drugs or to sex or to lie. But we were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. And that's why Nicodemus went to Jesus by night. He said, Rabbi, I knew that you are preaching the unadulterated gospel.
Amen.
And you are saying that the wages of sin is death. And now I want to ask you, how can I be born again? How can I enter into this heaven? How can I reach into the heavens of the heavens? And the Lord answered and said, he must be born again. Because we were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. And God says, because you're born messed up, you're born with all inheritance of demon activity. You're born with the old Adamic nature. We're born with evil out of our mind. Hallelujah. Nobody has to teach us to become wicked, but we were born wicked. We were born with corruption and perversion and demonic forces. We're born with evil and with demonic force. We're born and born with a wicked attitude. We're born with a evil mindset. We're born with jealousy. We're born with hypocrisy. We're born with jealousy. We're born with perversion. We're born with evilness. We're born with malice. We're born with lying.
Yeah.
We're born with gossiping.
Yeah.
We're born with perversion, with sexual nastiness. We're born with lying and cheating. now I am preparing a way for you that you must be born again. Yes, sir. So those who have been saying, oh, I was born this way. Yes, it's true. You tell you were born like the devil and twice as hell. You were born with a sinful nature. But there is a remedy.
Yes.
He must be born again. He must be born again. And now notice, God has prepared the way of the second birth. Nicodemus said, how can I enter into my mother's womb and be born again? Mm-hmm. Oh, hallelujah. Jesus said, the wind bloweth where thou listest, and you cannot see the wind, but you can hear the sound. And so is this birth. You must be born of the water and of the spirit and of the blood. Born again means transformation, metamorphosis, change, shifting, renovation, reincarnation, remission, restoration, rejuvenation, restitution. You must be born again. You must be changed, be transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Amen.
Nicodemus said, how can these things be? I'm a old man. How can I enter into my mother's womb the second time? You see, you got to understand that when you lack of knowledge, then you do not understand what God is saying. But what God is saying, this is not a physical birth, but this is a spiritual birth, because before we were born into the flesh, oh hallelujah, we were being, hallelujah, created in the spirit. And because we were created in the spirit, and we were in the spirit, created in the spirit, he's going to allow us to be birthed out in the spirit, through the spirit, that we can be changed, that we can have transition, that the life that we used to live, we'll live it no more. The word that we used to speak, we'll speak them no more. The place that we used to go, we go them no more. The things that we used to do, we do them no more, because it's a great change, for now you are now being born again. Born again means to be designed over, to be created, to be made new. This is what God is saying. He must be born again. Born of the Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Born again.
Yes, Jesus.
Now I know some of you don't like to hear this type of gospel, because this gospel is truth.
Yes,
so when you hear this gospel, you say it's true in word. It's true in chasm. It's judging me. Yes, I'm judging you. Because you are, hallelujah, carnal. And you are full of hypocrisy. And you are full of iniquity. And you're full of corruption. And you claim to have a praise, but your praise is contaminated. For today you praise God, and tomorrow you praise the devil. You're having a form of godliness, but deny the power thereof. You know And Jesus is saying, he must be born
again. Yes, Lord.
God bless you and keep the dream alive.